riding high, so you know. I'm going to take it upon myself to talk about two other teams. The Steelers and Commanders game. Now, that game was super exciting for me, personally, because I'm not a big Russ fan, but I'm happy to see that it looks like he found a home. Because Fields, yes, he's younger, probably get him on the cheaper, and maybe they keep both of them. But Russ is kind of looking like Seattle Russ, where, you know, he's able to make those passes that Fields wasn't able to make. And his cadence on the last play to seal the game, which that rookie for Washington, I don't believe you should get punished, but I think you need to run some extra sprints next practice. Because I don't know how the hell you jump off like that knowing that they possibly weren't going to go for it. They're just trying to waste the time. You know what I mean? That game was awesome. Also, Cowgirls.
Oh, no, wait, hold on. You can't just think. Yeah, come on. You ain't going to give us no mean Mills, no talk.
Okay, no, I didn't know if you guys Mills watched that game. I watched it. Like, you know me, man. I got the phone going. I got screen over here, screen over there, like sound off, just watching all these games. So I'm not too sure what games you guys really watched compared to which ones you did. But if you watched the Washington game, let me know how you feel about it, sir. Sorry.
Yeah, no, I watched some of it. It was a very entertaining game, like you said. Listen, I think Russ, it has to do what Mills always preach about. It's coaching, right? I think he's buying into the system of, you know, Mike. So it's coaching and everything. They have a good defense. And at this point, do you guys put the Steelers up on the ranking?
In what regards?
As in, like, you know, like a Super Bowl contender team high up there or what?
Not with Russ?
They're a playoff team for sure.
Definitely a playoff team.
I don't know about all that.
Ooh. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know about
that. Not with Russ Wilson, no.
Yeah. Also, I want to state, Kyler Murray, congrats to breaking the franchise record on the Jets. That is tough. 16 or 17 completed passes in a row. So,
yeah.
Shouts out to that young man, because a couple years ago, they were saying, hey, this guy don't pay attention to the plays. He's too busy playing video games, kicking his feet up. And, hey, that same head coach is somewhere else. But, yet again, that head coach is with Washington. And you see what Daniels is doing. So, I don't know how to parse that one other than maybe.
They just couldn't see eye to eye.
Yeah, I was about to say that. You know what I mean? They really couldn't see eye to eye on that one. Even Kansas City, which we're going to talk about as well, too, because they've got a horseshoe up their butt. There's no doubt about it. No, they shouldn't have won that game.
Hold on. No, they shouldn't have never won, but pause that.
Yeah, well, hold on.
Pause that.
Listen, back up a bit.
I keep forgetting we got new guys here, so, you know, you got to watch what you say and stuff, you know what I mean? I try to keep it kid-friendly and still got to pause. Like, hey, yo, pause.
Yo, so back up a bit. Remember last week on Stereo, King, coming back for you, when we were telling you that your Baltimore Ravens win against the Denver Broncos was the best win. Clearly shows why against the Chiefs.
You can't say that because the Chiefs, Patrick Mahomes is playing his worst year ever right now. Can we agree on that?
I don't think he is.
No?
Statistically, okay, from a standpoint of fantasy, statistics, if you want to go by the numbers, whatever. Yeah.
By that,
bro, he's literally finding, like, Andy Reid and him is literally finding ways to make plays. Now, yes, they should have lost against Denver, but defensively, you know, they made special teams, they came up with the block. Cool,
but no, this is what I'm saying though. Last year, their defense was sound, but this year, the defense is taking
their defense is the one that's carrying them,
yeah,
exactly. Compared to years prior, where it was the offense and the defense was just bend, don't break,
right.
So that's why I'm like, you know, I feel that this is his worst year we're ever going to see him playing in. It's not to poo-poo on him. It's just to say that they are a complete team. So this win against the Broncos, compared to the Ravens win against the Broncos, I think this one holds more weight because the Ravens offensively are a juggernaut. Defensively, they're shaky, baby. You know what I mean? They let a lot of dumb stuff happen. But for the Chiefs, I feel like their defense is super strong, and their offense is what needs work. And yet again, it's due to injury. I mean, I'm happy they brought Kareem Hunt back. You know, D-Hop, that the game prior to that one when they played the Bucks, like, those catches are ridiculous. That was vintage D-Hop, but, you know, I'm not too sure about these Chiefs. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, they'll make it to the playoffs, but they're one injury or one bad play away from being eliminated. You know what I mean? Yeah, the Lucky Charms is going to run out sometime.
Really? I don't know, man. Mahomes is Mahomes, and he gets to the playoffs, he might just see a different Mahomes.
Well, I'm not saying they're not going to get to the playoffs. Don't get it twisted.
In the playoffs, you might just see that whole Mahomes that we're all used to seeing.
But yet again, I'm not putting it all on Mahomes. I'm saying the offense as a whole is a little lackluster. And it's due to them bringing in new people. And
Kelsey,
you know,
slow down. Kelsey's not the same old Kelsey.
But how are you supposed to be the same old Kelsey? You've been in the league for like 13 years. Eventually, he's going to slow down.
Well, that's why you got Gray, the backup tight end. He's really been balling.
Yeah, he's been balling too. And yet again, D-Hop and Kareem Hunt are great additions. Kareem Hunt came from that system. Yeah, I mean, I don't think a lot of people remember that was his first team, and then he went to the Browns, the little trip, and then came back, right? And shouts out to Andy Reid too, man. The man is the land of many second chances.
I
appreciate him for that because he's a real one.
A real one.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But yet again, you know, what did you guys take from that Bronco game, though? What's your guys' thoughts about the Broncos?
The division game, and the Chiefs should have lost, but they just did it. They just find ways to win. We always been saying that. They just find ways to win the game. And that's just championship caliber type of situation.
Yeah.
You can't say nothing to it. We can't blame the refs. They literally got the block.
Mm-hmm.
Won the game.
Yeah, they kept picking on that one individual. I guess he was the weak link in the chain. They figured out, you know, how to get over.